want to remind you of a few things. You have a right to counsel. You have a right, even though you're a lawyer yourself, you have a right to a lawyer. Secondly, if at any time you believe that you are discussing matters that you want to discuss in camera, our committee has agreed that you can make such an application. We shall meet in camera to consider the matter. If we believe that it's a matter that should be held in camera, we'll hold it in camera. If it's a matter that should be held in public, we shall refuse your application and come back and hold it in public. The third thing is that we are a committee of parliament. We are not a court of law. We are not a police investigation team. So you will not cross-examine any other witness who is going to appear before the committee. Neither will any other witness cross-examine you. But after you give your evidence, members, you are a witness before the committee. You are not a complainant, you are not a plaintiff. And so everybody is a witness. Nobody is more of a superior witness than the other. So after you give your evidence, the members of the committee will ask you questions to clarify issues that they seek clarification. So those are the primary comments that I want to make. Do you have anything to say?
No, Mr. Chairman, I agree entirely with you.
So I want it to be put on record that you do not want to exercise your right to counsel, or you do?
No, I don't. Thank you very much.
Honorable Osei-Owusu, you are aware of the terms, so we wrote you a letter stating the terms of reference of this committee.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Now, the first reference is to establish whether First Deputy Speaker, Honorable Joseph Osei-Owusu, your good self, took money from Energy Minister, Mr. Boacha Ajaku, and gave it to Minority Chief Whip, Alhaji Mohammed Muteka, to be distributed to members of the Appointments Committee. What do you know about it? Can you tell the committee?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, on the 27th of February, late afternoon, we're in the chamber. I think Mr. Speaker has suspended sitting.
Sorry, Mr. Chairman. Did I hear you say 27th of February?
Sorry.
Or January.
January. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Chairman, sorry. Mr. Speaker has suspended sitting. The Appointments Committee's second report was pending. Mr. Chairman, around 4 p.m. thereabout, a friend sent me a WhatsApp message. And the WhatsApp message said, one Ablodepe was...
Excuse me, sorry. No telephone calls. No telephone calls. Don't even put your phone on silent. Don't pick your call. Sorry, it wasn't you, but I'm just making a point. If your phone rings, you're in contempt. If you lift up your phone, you're in contempt. And I'll ask you to be removed from this meeting immediately. This is a very serious exercise we are undertaking. Thank you. Please continue.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. That one Ablodepe was reporting from Parliament that the then nominee, Mr. Boacha Ajaku, had brought to me, Osei-Owusu, 100,000 Ghana cedis to be distributed among members of the Minority and the Appointments Committee so that he would be passed by Parliament. I was surprised. So I sought to look out for who the reporter was. I assumed then that he was a member of the Parliamentary Press Corps. So I was shown the leader of the Parliamentary Press Corps. And I showed him the message, said they should help me find who that person is. Because I thought that such a report, false as it is, he may have a reason for putting that out. So I wanted to meet the person. Then they said, no, he's not among the Parliamentary Press Corps, and that he was a former staffer at the office of the president of former President John Mahama. Well, because of that, I did not take it seriously. I went and showed the post to the minority leader and the deputy. Now look at what somebody is publishing. And we just dismissed it with a laugh, thinking that it was one of those who are engaged in partisan reportage. So practically, we ignored it. But within an hour, other members of parliament showed me some other publications from I think Banjo Online and Peace FM Online. And those publications had attributed their statement, this time, to a member of parliament, Honorable Mahama Yariga. Mahama Yariga was in the chamber, but just at the time, the speaker came in.
Sorry, one of these. The gentleman standing behind the witness, why are you standing there?
I was told that the reflection was against why I should be there.
Continue, please.
Mr. Chairman, because of that, when the chairman came in, it was this report of the nominees, five of them, which was to be discussed. The report was that three of them be approved by consensus and the remaining two be by majority. But before the report could be taken, the minority leader sought leave of the speaker that will go into a conclave of the leadership and members of the appointment committee. So we went into the speaker's office in the chamber block. When we went,
I don't want to interrupt you, but if you just said that you were going to discuss a report.
Yes.
Five of them. Three was by consensus, two were by majority.
Yes, sir.
Who were the three who were by consensus? Who were the two who were by majority, if you can remember?
I think, if I recall correctly, the three were Honorable Minister for Education, Honorable Minister for Communication, and Honorable Minister for Local Government.
I don't think it would be communication. Communication was not among the second. Communication was among the third. But who were the two? Let's remember, you've done a lot of vetting.
That's right.
But who were the two?
But the two were Honorable Minister Designate for Energy and Senior Minister Designate, Honorable Yasafu Mafu.
So the Honorable Minister Designate for Energy is Honorable Bwache Jaku, the one who is alleged
to have given us the bribe. Right.
Okay. Continue, please.
So, when we went into conclave, the issue was on the day we vetted the two nominees, as is our practice, as soon as we finish, we take a decision on whether the nominee is passed or by consensus or by majority. In respect of Honorable Yasafu Mafu and Honorable Bwache Jaku, the minority members on the committee made it clear that they would not support them. However, the minority leader requested the committee and me, the chair, to hold on with bringing out the report because we were doing further consultations.
You said the minority said they wouldn't support them. What did the majority say?
The majority said we supported them. So the conclusion was that they will be recommended to be approved by majority. And by standing orders, if it is by a majority, it means that we should go into a secret voting. And that was clearly contained in the report. Indeed, that was the report that was placed before the House. However, the report was delayed because these three members were among the first set of people that were vetted. But we did not add them to the first report because the minority leader had requested for time to do further consultations with his team on whether they should continue to hold the objection or not. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Chairman, at this meeting, when the Speaker allowed the request by the minority leader, after which we went into conclave in the Speaker's office, this publication had then come out. But the minority on the committee, headed by the minority leader, was in the company of the minority chief whip, Honorable Ayagi, a member of the appointments committee, Honorable Samson Ahi, a member of the appointments committee, Honorable Samuel Kujetu, a member of the committee, Honorable Eric Opoku, a member of the committee, Honorable Yele Chire, a member of the committee. They pointed out what the nominees had said at the vetting, which they did not like. They found offensive. One was about Honorable Boche Jakon's claim that the NDC government had bought 3 FURs or something, and they said they wanted the evidence. He had actually brought the evidence to me earlier. I had given it to the minority leader, who had also given it to the minority chief whip. But the chief whip said he couldn't find what he was looking for. So I had called Mr. Boche Jakon in, and he had come to mark the report for me, after which I returned it to Honorable Muntaka. Now, at that meeting, they called the immediate past Deputy Minister for Power, Honorable Jinapo, and he came to confirm that indeed those things that are contained in the report were a fact, except that they thought that in one case there had not been financial commitment. So they dropped that. But they were not happy with Boche Jakon saying that the World Bank was breathing heavily on the neck of John Mahama. And they were not happy with Mr. Yasuf Mafu's answer to the CNTCI loans. So they were given the opportunity to represent the evidence in words and expressions that was acceptable to them.
Let's restrict ourselves to Mr. Boche Jakon. He was given the opportunity where?
At the Speaker's office. That was the evening that they were going to move the motion. Indeed, the motion had been moved, and the 3 which were to be approved by consensus had been approved. But the 2 on which we were going to cast a vote, it was when the vote was to be taken that the minority there requested that we go into a conclave, which it is a report of the conclave that I've given. By that time, this allegation was already on air. So at that meeting, after they had been satisfied, the minority members had been satisfied.
To find out which allegation was already on air.
So, Chairman, the allegation that Boche Jakon had given me money to be distributed to members of the minority had already, as I said, had been published by, in addition to what a friend sent me, it has all been published on My Joy Online and Peace FM Online, which had been shown to me. It was that attribution which had been made to Honorable Ayariga, that he had made that allegation on Radio Gold, and they were reproducing it. So in the conclave, after they had shown that they were satisfied, the minority side, and were willing to withdraw their objection and to agree for the report to be amended, that Honorable Yasuf Mafu and Mr. Boche Jakon be passed by consensus, we're going to leave. And I said, no, there was this allegation already in the public domain, and Honorable Ayariga is the one alleged to have made that allegation, so we should discuss that matter at that meeting. All the minority members said, oh, Mr. Speaker, take your time, cool down, cool down. I said, how can I cool down? This allegation is made, is already in the public domain. Here we are. The person who made the allegation is here. It was at that point that Honorable Okujeto Ablakwa said, oh, because Ajakun said our president was corrupt, referring to President John Mahama, we were spreading the corruption allegation. So then the mood in the room changed. We all laughed with it. Oh, so this was all there was to it.
He said that in jest, or?
No,
the way you said, you all laughed.
Yes.
You're not sure whether it was, the meeting was a meeting held In camera?
Yes.
An in-camera meeting?
Yes.
From what you are saying now, when he said that, it brought out the tension.
Mr. Speaker. Because I was insisting that that matter be investigated before we leave the room. But when he said that they created that to spread the corruption, then I dropped my insistence. So when I came to report on the floor of the House, the conclusion that had been reached, and also sought leave to amend the report, I added in the statement that indeed this meeting has shown that the allegation of corruption, the people who created have confessed that they created that for equalization because the President Mahama had been accused of corruption. So, Speaker, all the people who were in the meeting were in that room that evening. If that were not so, I would have thought that somebody would object that what I was saying on the floor of the House.
Chairman,
Speaker, that would be borne out by the answer.
Mr. Chairman, sorry to butt in again. A witness made a statement that the people who made the allegation, so far he mentioned one person, the person of Honorable Okunjeto Abnakwa. Would you inform this committee who the people who made the allegation?
But you didn't even say that Honorable Ablaba made an allegation.
No.
You said that it is restricted, but he didn't make an allegation.
Right.
And then I asked him whether he made it in jest. They all laughed, and he's not in a position to tell. But the person who I've heard him say made allegation was Honorable Ayala. But if you're asking who else was in the room, he has mentioned the names. He mentioned the names of those who were in the room. I remember Honorable Ileche, Honorable Ayaga himself, he's mentioned it. So
yeah.
He's still not saying that anybody else has made an allegation apart from Honorable Ayaga.
Yeah.
I just want to clarify.
Mr. Speaker, in the report I made on the floor of the Parliament, I use the word the people who made the allegation.
Okay.
Right. But it is because it was Honorable Ayaga who is reported to have made a statement on Radio Gold. But it was Honorable Okunjeto who confessed, whether it is a confession or saying in jest, that they put that out as an equalization because Honorable Jaco had said that Honorable Sir John Mahama was corrupt. That's why I used the term the people who made the allegation. And you got here, I think this is clear now. I'm talking about Honorable Ayaga and then Honorable Okunjeto Abnakwa. Because Ayaga is the one who is reported. Okunjeto is the one who is offering the explanation for that report. And Mr. Speaker, when I made that report on the floor of the House.
So apart from these people that you mentioned, who else was there?
At the meeting, Honorable Suhihini, Honorable Eric Opoku.
You mentioned that. Who else was there from the majority side?
From the majority side, it was the majority leader and myself, yes, two of us.
Honorable Speaker, I've been a speaker before. What happens in the speaker's lobby? Sometimes
the speaker, I take your hint, but we have now moved it from the speaker's lobby onto the floor of the House. When I reported on that, in the course of amending the report.
What day was that?
The same Friday, 27 January.
The clerk will get us a copy. We'll study it.
Yes, Mr. Speaker.
We'll study it.
Thank you. So, indeed, after that, we expected that the matter would die. But Parliament rose that evening after 7, and some of us were going to Koforidua for the induction call for new members of Parliament. It was on the way going that I received reports that Honorable Ayaga has gone back or taken to social media and saying that the allegation he made was true. I got to Koforidua rather late, but the following morning, around 10, when the program was on, I received several calls. When I checked, they were coming from CTFM and Joy FM. CTFM, I think they have a Saturday morning program. They called me and I told them clearly that what Honorable Ayaga has put out It's not true. Indeed, I use words which I have now been advised not to use because it's unparliamentary. But I insisted that it was not true, it was a lie.
I asked not to use it, so why do you say that and use it again?
Well,
so you withdraw what you just said.
Chairman, I withdraw. I was only reporting what had said.
No, I don't want you to. They've asked you not to use it.
Very well, Mr. Speaker. So, Joy FM also called me, and I responded the same way. They insisted that Honorable Ayariga says that it was Honorable Muntaka who told him. And I said that if Muntaka told him that, Muntaka was also telling an untruth, in that neither I or I and Muntaka have never discussed anything to do with money, neither have I taken any money from Honorable Ejakun for myself or for anybody. The Speaker, throughout the weekend, the discussions that were going on was terrible. Very presumptuous conclusions drawn by people in the media. So I came to a conclusion that this matter should not end here. I should bring it back to the floor of the House. So, Mr. Speaker, on Tuesday, I made a statement on the floor of the House. My main intention was to go to court. And the reason I wanted to go to court was that if this matter was not settled at a forum where the accusers and I would face each other, it may still be difficult for people to believe that that was the truth. What I was saying was the truth. And the difficulty is that when something is not true, all you can say is that it is not true. Whereas those who are alleging go around, take all corners.
To all they can say is that it is true.
Oh, they are bringing in people from here, inviting, you know.
So you two bring people to say it's not true.
But how can I bring people when something has not happened? You know, so I considered, I had a meeting with my lawyers. I must confess that my main lawyer is my junior. I trained in Kofrodia. Fortunately, I was in Kofrodia. So we had long meetings. We came to a conclusion that the challenge any litigation with an MP would have is how to serve a process. The constitution is very clear. You cannot serve a process on a member when he is going into or returning from. And indeed, if you have the person not willing to cooperate, you can never serve a process. Mr. Speaker, the conclusion then was to seek the Speaker's permission, because the Speaker can permit service through him. So the whole tenor of the statement was to put out what had happened and to seek the Speaker's permission, consent, to serve, not to take the action. To take the action is my right, but to serve processes through the Speaker's office to Honorable Ayariga, who had made those disparaging remarks about me. Well, the leadership went into conclave and they came to a conclusion that, what do you want? If you're a speaker, you're no longer an ordinary member. You'll be presiding. So if you're the presiding officer, also in litigation with members, it will affect the quality of your leadership, and I should avoid matters which make it personal, because my position is quite unique. So the conclusion was that what you want is for the truth to be established. So if a committee was set up here and to investigate, it will serve the same purpose. If it is not true, it will be found out. If it is true, it will be established. So, Mr. Speaker, if you ask me that the allegation that I have taken money from Honorable Ejakun, whether for myself or for any member of my committee, is false, and that I've never done any such thing, neither have I discussed anything to do with money with Honorable Ayariga or any member for that matter, and Honorable Minority Chief Whip, Honorable Mubarak Muntaka. Mr. Speaker, I must say also, that some other things that have come to my notice subsequent, which I think this committee must know. The person who was purported to be reporting from here, was actually reporting live. And about a week after, a friend brought me a copy of what had been published. Indeed, what had been put out suggests that I had actually gone into hiding on that day. And I would like to play that with your permission for you to hear, for everybody to hear.
No.
The extent of the plot
no.
that had been...
No, we'll listen to that first. And then if we want to play it, then we'll play it. You don't catch us, take us by surprise. You know, Mr. Speaker, the rules of Parliament. Give evidence now, you want to play tips. So tonight, we'll listen to it. If we think it's necessary, we'll play it the next time.
Very well, the Chairman. The Chairman, how do I tender? I send it to your phone or?
You send it to the clerk's phone. So that afterwards, the clerk will give his number.
Very well. Okay, so after this, I will forward it to the clerk's phone so that.
Well, Mr. Speaker, yeah. Sorry, one minute, please. Sorry.
So, the Chairman, what I'm saying is that if you listen to the tape and other statements made by a colleague, let me also put on record that. That same evening, when we were leaving Parliament, Honorable Katie Amund walked up to me and he asked me, is it true what you said, that they said this was created to level up the allegation against John Mahama? And I said, yes, it was. And President John Mahama. Fortunately, Honorable Okudjete walked to us, and I'm saying, here, he's the one who said it. Then Honorable Katie Amund asked him, did you say that? And he said, yes, we wanted you to feel the same heat as John Mahama is feeling.
President John Mahama.
Sorry, I'm quoting him, what he said then. Okay. He didn't say President Mahama. You know. So, Mr. Speaker, this was on the corridor, walking up to our offices, and Honorable Okudjete said this in the presence of Honorable, but in a response to a question put up by Honorable Katie Amund. Now, in the face of these, I've considered these to be some of the political games, and I was willing to let it go until Honorable Ayaya went and sat at Joy FM on their flagship program and continued these untruths about me. I think that this committee must establish whether indeed. As a term of it, I have received any money and distributed any money to any member. In fact, all publications that have since come to my notice suggest that they said the chairman was the one, the conduit for distributing bribes. The chairman, yes, those all publications that I've since seen. And they are comfortable reading that and not saying anything when none of them have discussed money with me or at any point in time. Whether it is Muntaka or any member.
Honorable Muntaka.
Sorry, Mr. Speaker. Honorable Muntaka or another. I mean, I find that I get emotional over these things.
I've been looking at all of you, your demeanor and your attitude at the Appointments Committee further to this. And you have managed to not be emotional and continue to work together. So please, don't get emotional about this. You are a lawyer of many years standing. In these matters, you are a politician. Don't get emotional about this. We are here to establish the truth. Be assisting us.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I must confess that the first 1 week after, from Monday, it was very difficult. It was difficult for me to look at some people in the face. I was visibly angry, taking photograph of me and sending it to me, seeing how I looked. That the thing, it was showing too clearly that I was not myself, and I was truly not myself. I had discussed with the leader whether it was possible to disband the committee and reconstitute it so that the public confidence in the institutions of Parliament will be restored. But after we looked at the standing orders, we found that it may not be possible.
Don't worry, you have. You and the committee have handled yourself with dignity, and we shall continue to handle ourselves at this matter with dignity as we also continue to pursue the truth. before my members come in, we have listened to Mr. Ayaga's Joy FM interview, and we have also we also have a transcript with us. Ayaga did not say that he took the money from you or you discussed money with him. What we see from our transcript, Mr. Ayaga said that he was told from the transcript. Have you heard anywhere, or do you have any evidence that suggests, or Mr. Ayaga himself said, or says, or reports that you were the one who gave him some money?
What I listened to on Joy FM and on Radio Gold was that he said Honorable Muntaka told him.
Yes. Okay. Now, you said that you had taken the decision to, as it were, recommend Mr. Ajaku by majority.
Yes, Mr. Speaker. Indeed, the report that we laid on the floor of the House would attest to that, that the vote will be taken on Honorable Ejaku and Honorable Osafumaf.
We'll ask the clerk to supply us a copy of that report. Am I correct also in saying that that decision was taken immediately after the meeting ended?
Yes, Mr. Speaker. It is the practice. As soon as we finish proceedings, we take them one by one. Nominee number this, vote. If there's consensus, if there's no, in fact, we used to have what we call unanimous, but I checked the standing orders and I found that there was no such thing as unanimous. So I dropped that. So it's either consensus or by majority. So that evening, in each, I think Mr. Zafumafu was the first to appear on a Monday. We took the decision on him that evening. Then Mr. Jaku came either the day after or so. He also, we took the decision on him the same day.
I know you said it, but just for emphasis, I want to see whether I understand you. So when you submitted the report, the position was still majority in favor, minority against.
Exactly, Mr. Chairman.
And you also said that it was the minority leader who said that you must, you see whether his people, or you see whether his members will agree to consensus.
Yes, Mr. Speaker. Indeed, the night before the report was late, I was staying up here late. And earlier on, the minority leader had a discussion, said, look, let's pass them on, but let me confer with the majority chief whip. Within 30 minutes, the majority chief whip called back and said, no, they do not agree to the consensus.
Majority or minority chief whip?
The minority chief whip.
So, Honorable Harry Jisu, who is the ranking member of your committee,
yes,
was having discussions with the chairman of the committee.
Yes.
In Parliament, is it normal for the ranking member and for the chairman to have discussions after the committee has met? Is it normal?
Yes, Mr. Speaker. Irregularly, no decision regarding the management or administration of the committee is taken in isolation. It's always in consultation with your ranking member.
So even though the report was being done, majority going one way, minority going another way, you and your ranking member continue to be in discussion.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
And what was the purpose of that discussion?
Mr. Chairman, as I recall, the first report should have contained all the first batch
that
appeared. There were supposed to be eight.
Yeah.
We delayed that of the first two because the minority leader requested that we should allow him some time to do further consultation with his colleagues. His position was that it will not be a good way to start by going into division straight away. We should continue to strive to build consensus. So,
do you agree with that position?
Well, that is supposed to be...
Do you agree with that position?
Exactly, yes.
Let me ask you another question. And so, the... minority leader and yourself, when you couldn't arrive at a decision, decided that you would divide it into two.
Yes. Yes, Mr. Chairman.
And those who was by consensus, you let them, you did a separate report.
No, Mr. Chairman, I put, you mean the first batch of 8 people?
You had a number of people who are vetted. You vet a number of people over a week. The president brings forward names to parliament, is seconded to you. Now, his first batch of ministers had been vetted by you, if I understand from what you are saying.
Yes.
Of the first batch, you had passed all, you had agreed to pass all by consensus. But there were two of them that you decided that you passed them by a majority. Am I right?
That is so, Mr. Chairman.
So, ordinarily, you should have had one report covering all of them.
No, Mr. Chairman, for the week, the number of persons we vetted for that particular week were...
What I want to find out is whether those two were delaying the presentation of the report of the other ones that you have passed by consensus.
No, Mr. Chairman, when we decided that we would do, out of the 8 that were vetted first and second days, we would do the 6 whilst the minority leader continued his consultation on the 2. So when we were doing the second report,
Then you added the 2.
We added the 2.
So it'd be because you couldn't agree on those 2, they were not passed on the
first report, no.
Even though they had been vetted, ordinarily they should have been part of the first report.
That's right.
Okay. So you added them to the second report.
That is so, Mr. Chairman.
And if there had not been agreement, you would have brought it forward to Parliament for a vote.
Indeed, I brought it to Parliament for a vote. Okay. It was when the vote was to be taken. In that report, I broke it into 2. These 3 are to be approved by consensus. These 2 by majority. So the voice vote had been taken in respect of the consensus. The vote was to be taken, the secret ballot, was to be taken on the remaining 2. It was at that point that the minority there requested that we go into a conclave. And that's when we moved to the speaker's lobby.
Did the Honorable Bwacha Jagu, did he agree to make the changes or submit to what the minority didn't want in his report? Did he agree to do that?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. There were 2 of them, Honorable Yasaf Mafo and Honorable Bwacha Jagu. When we left the chamber and went, they were waiting in the speaker's lobby. So what the minority found offensive, they pointed out. Those they wanted proof. You brought the proof, Mr. Bwacha Jagu, and the immediate past deputy minister for power, who was in the chamber, was brought in to confirm or otherwise the things that were he had alluded to. But then his choice of words and expression, which they found offensive, they made him retract that or re-present it in a way that they found acceptable.
So, as you were leaving the speaker's lobby, can you tell us why you went back and decided to approve them by consensus?
It was because the reason for the minority members objecting to or not supporting their nomination had been resolved to the satisfaction of the minority members.
Was that brought to the floor, to the chamber?
Yes, Mr. Speaker, after it had been resolved in the speaker's lobby, we came to report on it, and then I amended the report in the chamber based on the consensus that had been reached at the speaker's lobby.
Thank you. Honourable members, do you have any questions?
Questions. And the first one is the conclave meeting. You mentioned at the conclave meeting, it was Honourable Okunjetu Ablakwa who spoke. Did Honourable Ayariga speak on the issue that you raised?
Mr. Speaker, he had raised his hand, but all the other members said, cool it down, take it easy. In fact, as soon as we entered the room, the minority leader said, oh, Mr. Speaker, you seem too visibly shaking. Please take it easy. But after I raised the issue that it be resolved as such, Ayaga did not speak. It was rather Okudzeto who spoke.
Honorable Ayaga, Honorable Okudzeto.
I'm sorry, I apologize. Honorable Ayaga, Honorable Okudzeto.
All their constituencies.
Very well, thank you.
Now, Honorable Joe Osei-Owusu, let me come back to issues of procedure at appointments committee. Do you or do you not expect consideration from nominees that appear before you?
No, Mr. Chairman, we do not expect consideration from nominees or anybody for that matter.
Honorable member, I thought that refers to the second point. I thought we exhaust the first terms of reference, then we move to the second, then move to the third.
Let me contain myself.
With the first. So then I'll just inform the nominee I inform the witness that we are dealing with a second terms of reference, then he can address that. Even though it is evidence he addressed it somehow, of course, we want him to address that specifically as well.
Maybe because he addressed it in
Yes,
past.
Yes.
Now, Honorable Joe Osei-Owusu, Honorable Ayariga is your colleague in the House. Did you, at any time, engage him one-on-one to find out from him why he went on air speaking or alleging, making this allegation against you?
No, Mr. Chairman, I wouldn't trust him to do any such thing.
Mr. Chairman, if I may continue.
Yes.
Now, apart from raising the issue at the conclave meeting, since you didn't trust Honorable Ayariga, did you raise it with his leadership?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. At the conclave meeting, I put it on the floor where the leadership were, that matter should be resolved there before we return to the chamber.
What do you mean by you didn't trust him?
He said whether I spoke to him, said I wouldn't trust him. After he had made those allegations, gone on air to repeat it, for me, I think it would be suicidal to get into any one-on-one meeting with him. It's very dangerous.
You don't want to die as well. So you sit at the appointments committee and none of you have discussed this?
No, Mr. Speaker, no. Once this committee has been set up, I'll let everything be discussed here.
Okay. Anyway, the speaker in setting up the committee also advised that the members should not discuss it. So I think, yes, Honorable Member.
Now, you also mentioned that Honorable Ayariga said he received the information that you brought money to Honorable Muntaka. Did you at any time confront Honorable Muntaka to confirm or deny the allegation?
Yes, Mr. Speaker. The evening that the information came to us, I did not confront Honorable Muntaka. However, the following morning, when Joy FM called me and I spoke to the matter, they called Honorable Muntaka, who also spoke. At that time, he said he was on his way to Koforidua. So at lunchtime, he came to me and said, sorry, I think you don't deserve this, but I don't know what I should say, what other he said. But at that point, he came to plead with me, apologize that I've been brought into the center of this to me.
Honorable Joseph, was Honorable Ayaga at Koforidua as well?
No, Mr. Speaker, the chairman.
He wasn't at Koforidua?
No. The chairman will probably know that the meetings were broken into two.
Yes.
But I was there because
of your position,
and I was to chair one of the sessions.
That was the session for the first,
the first MMP. Yes.
That's why, and Honorable Mutaka was there because
he was also a leader.
He's a leader.
Yes.
So you didn't have. So from that time, the only time that you confronted Honorable Ayaga or mentioned to you was when you met in the Speaker's lobby.
Yes.
Because you intended to go to court.
Yes.
And you were not going to discuss the matter with somebody who potentially would go to court.
Well, let me say that as at the time I was leaving Parliament that evening, I thought the matter was over because of what Honorable Kujete had said, what I'd repeated on the floor of Parliament, and since there had not been any reaction, I thought, and
yeah, so when you spoke on the floor of Parliament, nobody got up to mention this allegation.
No, I had said that the allegation that was as a result of
you had said certain things, this is the answer.
Right.
But I'm saying that after you said it, nobody got up to say anything about this allegation.
No.
After you said it, the question was put on the nominees.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
And after that, the House rules.
The House rules, yes.
Nobody tried to catch the Speaker's eye, to the best of your information.
I don't recall. Because the way I said, if anything happened behind me, I wouldn't know.
You mentioned that Joy FM interviewed you the following morning.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Did you monitor the program after you spoke?
Unfortunately, no. I was called from the table where I was supposed to have a program. So I practically, against protocol, when the speaker was sitting, I had to leave to go and do this. So I came back to leave, and he forgave me.
So you did not hear the views of Honorable Ayariga after you had spoken with Joy FM?
Regrettably, no.
And thereafter, you did not have information of what he said?
No, what was brought to my attention was a statement or an opinion written by the host, and that was even after I had made a statement on the floor of the House, saying that my statement had created the impression that MPs were immune to legal proceedings. I think the Sunday after, somebody forwarded it to me. And I called him. We had a discussion that I don't like argument on law at places where there's no judge. You know, if we are making legal argument, then there will be a judge to say who is right or who is wrong. But other than that, it's your opinion and mine. But I pointed out to him where I think he erred in his discussion. And we agreed that he could have probably discussed the thing in a different way. And we'll let it go.
Speaker, hold my fire for now.
I didn't know you had fire. I thought you were just... I didn't know we were fire. Because you had told me that we'll bring firefighters. You are just a compelling...
No fire,
that's it. Okay.
Honorable, is it the case that at the time you went into the closed-door meeting to discuss whether you could approve of the other two nominations by consensus, this bribery allegation had already gone out?
Mr. Chairman, I the first one I received was around 3:15 that afternoon, and we went into that. That was the what was sent to me by a friend journalist. Somebody had put it on his, I don't know whether Twitter or Facebook wall, and he copied it and forwarded it. She copied it and forwarded it to me, asking me whether that is true. I was amazed, you know. But after that, just before the speaker came in,
when I'm conferring, don't take a picture of me, please. It's nothing. Okay, let's focus on that. Just the clerk to the committee, I'm just asking to give you some information. So don't take a picture of me as if I'm planning a coup d'etat or something. Continue.
Yes. So just when, in fact, when the speaker was coming in, that my attention was drawn to those other publications on Major Online and PZFM Online. So I couldn't even read the content of that until after that I read and I found that indeed Honorable Ayaga had said that Honorable Muntaka had told him. So at the time I was asking that the matter be resolved in the conclave, I didn't even know that he had even cited his source as Honorable Muntaka. Okay.
At that meeting, was Honorable Eric Opoku in attendance?
Yes, he was, Chairman.
Honorable Sohini was in attendance?
Yes, he was.
Honorable Yilechire was in attendance?
Yes, he was.
Honorable Muntaka Mubarak was in attendance?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, he was.
Honorable Ejako Bwache, now the Energy Minister, was in attendance?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, he was there.
Now, in that closed-door meeting, did Honorable Sohini raise any issue relating to the bribery allegation?
No.
In that closed-door meeting, did Honorable Eric Poku raise any issue relating to the bribery allegation?
No, Mr. Chairman.
In that closed-door meeting, did Honorable Yilechire raise any issue relating to the bribery allegation?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Let me just ask you, did they have an opportunity to raise it? Was it a meeting that everybody could speak if the person wanted?
Well, the meeting was specifically to do with those things that the nominees had said at the appointment committee that the minority found offensive.
What I want to find out is the formality of the meeting. Was it like in the chamber that you have to be recognized? If you are not recognized, you can't speak. Was it that kind of meeting, or it was an informal meeting which they could have raised it? That's what I want to find out.
Mr. Chairman, it was an informal meeting, practically informal. Both nominees, it was pointed out to them what the minority found offensive, and they were offered opportunity to speak to those things.
So was it held in a...
At the speaker's lobby.
Yeah, was it held, was it held in a cordial atmosphere, or it was held in a, it was...
No, the atmosphere was normal. Very cordial and friendly.
Oh, you were the only person who was angry.
I guess so.
Continue.
Mr. Chairman, was it in that meeting that Honorable Okudjeto Abloka did say that they went on air to allege the bribery allegation because they wanted an equalization?
Yes, Mr. Speaker. Well, he didn't exactly use the word equalization, that because you said our president was corrupt, we're spreading the corruption allegation. It was at that meeting. He was standing right behind Honorable Sukini.
Did he say, or did any of the honorables whose names I've mentioned say that they had taken any money from Muntaka Mubarak?
Mr. Speaker, at that meeting, nobody said that.
Okay.
Honorable meeting. Of course, anybody can follow us.
Honorable Joseph.
Tell us, is this fire or?
No, it's not fire. Isn't it unusual that after you had heard Honorable Ayaruga had made this allegation about you, and you met in caucus, he did not speak to your face about what had been carried out there? That don't you find
opinion.
It?
I think I'm going to.
Not admit it.
Yes.
I
didn't want to not admit any question, but this one, please.
Very well.
These are matters that we can infer looking at the evidence. Honorable Fire. Yes, honorable meeting over.
Prior to the caucus meeting, you stated that you had heard the allegation of this bribery thing.
Is that correct?
When you say caucus meeting, you're talking about the meeting that was held?
Yeah, the meeting that
in the speaker's lobby. Held in the speaker's lobby.
Yes, please.
Okay. He calls
conclave,
it
the conclave.
The conclave, because yes. Caucus here has a meaning and understanding of this. So the conclave. Is it like the Pope's conclave or to resolve matters dealing with the two nominees?
Okay. Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Otherwise known as the conclave.
Yeah, otherwise known as the conclave.
Thank you.
Yeah, following that, you said after you had resolved to pass the two by consensus, you raised the issue of the bribery allegation.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. I insisted that
you also mentioned that the minority members in unison, but Ayarga raised his hand.
Yeah.
Was it in opposition? Or that he also supported it?
No, I think he wanted to say something at that meeting. But they said, Mr. Speaker, cool down, cool down, cool down. And then Honorable Okujeto brought in his explanation for what they were doing. That was what appeared to have me, for example. I thought that if it was only for the political purposes, I was not keen, it was the end of the matter. That was why I reported on it on the floor of the House, hoping that it will end there. Once members know the source and the reason, it will end there.
It means that you reported on it because as far as you were concerned, the matter had ended.
Yes.
Continue, Honorable Baba.
Mr. Speaker, in that case, it means that conclave meeting had two objectives. Is that correct?
Mr. Chairman, the second one, this was not part of the reason for going into that meeting. The meeting was requested by the minority leader. The meeting was to resolve whether or not the minority will remove their objection to the two nominees being approved by consensus. But just before we went into that meeting, it had come to my notice that these allegations have been made. So, after we had resolved the matter relating to the two nominees, I raised the matter that this allegation has been made, so it should be resolved at that meeting as well.
Mr. Speaker, I want to know, Mr. Chairman, I want to know from the witness whether the appointments committee ever discussed the payment of allowances to themselves.
That's the second point. So I think that members have. Do you have the terms of reference in front of you?
Regrettably, no.
So when the committee goes on recess, it doesn't give anybody the opportunity to have a chat to the witness. And I noticed that the witness just ignored the people who are trying to talk to. So thank you. I think that we will continue. You have seen the terms of reference.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Even though you've answered it, but I just want to ask you directly. Did you take any money from the energy minister, Mr. Bwachi Ajaku?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Honorable Joseph.
Yes, sir.
Did you give any money to the minority chief whip, Alhaji Mubarak Muhammad Muntaka, to distribute to his members on the minority side?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Or to any members of the appointments committee, even the majority, because the terms of reference, or to any members of the appointments committee?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Honorable Banda.
Honorable Osei-Owusu, were there any attempts by anybody, whether directly or indirectly, to bribe the appointment committee?
Mr. Chairman, the appointment committee as a group, from the time we sit to the time we finish, no stranger has participated in our meetings. No non-member have met with us as a group. And then I as an individual, nobody has attempted to bribe me. If anybody has done that to the members, I will not be in a position to say, but as a group, through me or in the meeting or as a person, nobody has attempted to bribe me or the group.
And you, why you take the decisions immediately after you finish?
Mr. Chairman, immediately we finish. We don't break. As soon as we clear the gallery, we decide on the nominees.
So you don't even do what we did now. You don't break at all.
No, we don't leave our tables. We sit by our tables and take the decision.
But I want to assure you that we didn't leave our tables for any evil. The way you are insisting that you don't leave your table, as if we left our table for some different. We didn't. We left our table for just 2 minutes to confer on a certain matter.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Honorable Peter.
Yes. Do you have any further information for this committee which will enhance our work?
I'm not sure. Regarding this matter.
Regarding this matter.
All of I know is what I've shared with you. A few other commentaries on radio and things. The one I want to share with you is a report that apparently was being made the same time that this allegation was being made. I mean, says that I had gone into hiding, that they were looking for me, they couldn't find me, and because of that, the report cannot be presented.
This hiding matter, don't worry about it. When our second deputy speaker was on official duty in Abuja, it was reported that I had gone into hiding in Ghanaian Times. That I couldn't be served, I was in hiding. So hiding, don't worry, this is not the first, and it may not be the last. So don't worry about hiding at all. We are interested in whether or not there was any bribery or attempt to bribe. Honorable Osei-Owusu.
Yes,
since you have nothing else to say, and since the committee has nothing else to ask you at this stage, I will ask that you submit your tape recording to the clerk. I'll also say that you are discharged. If the committee has any more need to invite you, we shall not hesitate to do that. I know you hold yourself in readiness. I want to just refer you to order 221 before I discharge you. And it reads as follows. The witness may, within 7 days from the date of receipt of the copy, suggest corrections due to inaccurate reporting, and the evidence shall be printed with such corrections as may be approved by the chairman. Your evidence will be sent to you. This committee does not intend to meet ad infinitum. So I direct that the evidence should be sent to you immediately today. And if you have, we are bridging the time. If you have any corrections, do it by Friday. And you can get back to the committee via, on Friday we'll be sitting. By Friday morning, if you have something to bring to us, we'll look at it. That will not be, public, it's very simple, just taking off evidence. Or after the sitting on Friday, if you see corrections, you can bring it to us.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
At this stage, I will discharge you. And thank you for attending onto the committee,
Thank you.